Mobile security is a top concern for every company these days, and for a good reason. In the new normal, your remote workforce is increasingly accessing corporate data from mobile devices. This means that the exposure to data breaches is greater than ever, and we've got the research to prove it. Over the past few months, researchers at Checkpoint have been observing an enormous rise in the number of attacks and data breaches that are coming in through the mobile endpoint. We've uncovered all sorts of new and dangerous types of attacks, including coronavirus-related malicious campaigns, sophisticated mobile ransomware attacks, and even mobile device management, MDM, getting weaponized to attack organizations. In this video, we'll be taking a look at key findings from our research team about these kinds of threats. Our findings underscore how important it is to be alert to mobile risks and to have visibility into this threat space. It also highlights how critical it is to have the necessary measures in place for fighting mobile threats. The first threat we want to discuss today is fake COVID-19 related apps. Since the very beginning of the COVID-19 outbreak, skilled threat actors have been exploiting people's concerns about the coronavirus. They spread mobile malware, including mobile remote access trojans, banker trojans, and premium dialers through apps that claim to offer coronavirus-related information and help. Checkpoint researchers have discovered 16 different malicious apps, all masquerading as legitimate coronavirus-related apps. These apps contain a range of malware that is focused on stealing users' sensitive information or generating fraudulent revenues from premium rate dialers. It's important to note that none of the malicious apps were available through an official app store, and this is a key takeaway for your mobile workforce. Since today most of us access corporate email and other company assets from our mobile devices, an info stealer installed on the device that steals credentials could be the starting point of an attack on the corporate network. We would strongly recommend communicating this danger to your employees to make sure they don't download any app that does not come from a legitimate source. The second threat we want to talk about is the device itself. The threat to mobiles is not just about phishing or malicious URLs and apps. Rather, the mobile device itself is extremely vulnerable as well. In a recent research report titled Achilles, the Checkpoint research team published the results of an extensive security review of one of the biggest chip manufacturers, Qualcomm Technologies. Qualcomm provides a wide variety of chips that are embedded in over 40% of the mobile phones on the market, including high-end phones from Google, Samsung, LG, Xiaomi, OnePlus, and more. We found that there are more than 400 vulnerabilities within this chip, and that these vulnerabilities can have the following impact on the phone users. Attackers can turn the phone into a perfect spying tool without any user interaction required. The information that can be leaked from the phone includes photos, videos, call recordings, real-time microphone data, GPS and location data, and more. Attackers may be able to render the mobile device constantly unresponsive, and the owner would have to factory reset the device, permanently deleting its entire contents, including photos, videos, contact details, etc. Malware and other malicious code can completely hide its activities and become unremovable. So, it's important to know that it's not just what you click or what you download. The threat to mobile phones can be built in and hidden in the device itself, just waiting for someone to exploit it. Our third threat for this discussion is how ransomware has gone mobile. Ransomware attacks have been a part of the security landscape for a long time now. We are familiar with infamous malware such as CryptoLocker, WannaCry, and Ryuk, all of which have caused tremendous damage to organizations and private assets around the world. And while ransomware has just started to take its first steps into the mobile world, it's evolving fast, with malware developers and attackers leveraging their experience to launch ransomware attacks on mobile devices that are causing a lot of disruption. One example comes from the Black Rose Lucy malware family, originally discovered in September 2018 by Checkpoint. Lucy is a malware as a service botnet and dropper for Android devices. And now, nearly 2 years later, it is back with new ransomware capabilities that enable it to take control of the victim's mobile devices, making various changes and installing new malicious applications. When downloaded, Lucy encrypts files on the infected mobile device and displays a ransom note on the browser window that claims to be an official message from the FBI, accusing the victim of having pornographic content on their devices. The message also states that in addition to locking the device, the user's details have been uploaded to the FBI's cybercrime department's data center, along with a list of other offenses that the user is accused of committing. The victim is then instructed to pay a $500 fine and to provide their credit card information. In our follow-up research, Checkpoint researchers have discovered more than 80 malware samples that were distributed mainly through social media links and instant messaging apps that are associated with this new mobile variant of Lucy. And we are also seeing that the mobile threat landscape is continuously closing the gap with traditional cyber attacks. The next step will probably be double extortion in mobile. This is a combination of infostealer and ransomware, first breaching and stealing corporate data saved on the device, and only then encrypting the files on the device and asking for ransom. And finally, let's take a look at a phenomenon first seen in the wild, corporate MDM used to distribute malware. The Checkpoint research team has also recently discovered a new Kerberos variant, with Kerberos being a banking Trojan and remote access Trojan attack on Android mobile devices. And we have seen it in action, targeting a multinational conglomerate. What's shocking about this variant is that the malware was distributed through the company's mobile device management, MDM, server, and reached over 75% of the company's devices. MDM's most notable feature, and probably the reason for its existence, is also its core weakness. This is its single, central control of the entire mobile network. If this platform is breached, so is the entire mobile network. So, what was the damage to the conglomerate? We know that every credential used from an unprotected device was reported to the command and control server. We also know that every text message was intercepted, enabling the criminals to potentially exploit two-factor authentication codes received through text messages. If one unprotected device was used by an administrator who then tried to access corporate resources with their credentials, those credentials, along with any two-factor authentication SMS codes, were compromised. Due to the extent of this malware's capabilities, the company decided to factory reset all devices just to be on the safe side, so that no residue of the malware, nor the actor, would potentially remain on devices. Just think about the burden of having to delete, and hopefully also be able to restore, all the data from hundreds of employee devices. This campaign shows us how important it is to understand the difference between managing and securing mobile devices. While MDM does offer an easy way to manage mobile devices, security cannot be automatically guaranteed, and this fact must not be ignored. The danger is real. The damage is great. Stay tuned. In our next episode, we will discuss the five key considerations for selecting the optimal mobile security solution.